first thing I'm going to do is mark the eye for a toric lens. So this is a Robomarker, and this is a pretty nifty device. No matter how I turn this device, the angle still stays the same. So for this particular eye, I'm just going to mark at 0 and 180. And what I want to do is get the patient to sit nice and upright, which is exactly what you're doing there, and the head nice and neutral, and then with the eyes looking straight ahead at a point on the wall. So he's doing really well here. I'm just going to open the eye. So what I usually use is my thumb and my little finger, and that allows me to actually project this in like so. And so as you can see what I'm doing, I'm trying to keep the two prongs perfectly level and try to hit the eye or touch the eye at exactly the same time, which is what I'm doing with this now. And it just feels like a bit of a push on the eye. They've both contacted the eye. I put a little bit of a press and then I take it away, and it leaves these two fine lines, and that's the way that the surgeon can then line up the lens really effectively. And just showing that again, as I move in, little finger, thumb, eye looking straight ahead. Now this patient is fantastic, looking exactly straight as he's told. A lot of patients have difficulty with that. And so he's just doing really well to be able to look forward. That's great. What I do for this mark, this is another marking the eye for a toric lens. I get the patient to keep their head nice and neutral, their body is nice and neutral, looking straight ahead at a place on the wall. And all I have to do now is mark 0 and 180. You don't want to do this with the patient lying down, because then the axis of the eye changes subtly. So what I want to do is, again, little finger opening up the lower lid, thumb opening up the eye top lid, and then just put a mark medially and laterally, and that allows them to align the lens. That's really good. You did really well.